right, thank you. Thank you so much for the standing ovation. That's very nice of you. I don't know how I followed the dance routine. Usually I'm a pretty entertaining speaker, but I feel completely humbled in the presence of that. Let me just say, first of all, that people ask me how I decided to introduce the same-sex marriage bill. Well, what happened was I was sitting and watching TV one day, and there was a discussion of California, and they said, you know, I forget the number, like five other states have legislation proposed to legalize same-sex marriage. But Pennsylvania was not one of those. And I said, you know, I can't do much in the state Senate given its composition, but I can do something about that. And we introduced that bill that week because it was time that that people in the gay and lesbian community knew that some people were fighting for them and fighting for their equality, which is what we're going to continue to do. I also want to say, thank you. I also want to say, I wrote an editorial in a number of newspapers, which you can Google, on precisely the point the previous speaker made, which is, it is really creepy for the minority to vote on the rights of the majority to vote on the rights of the minority. It's one thing to have a referendum on whether to float a bond to build a bridge, but to have a vote on whether a minority group has basic human rights just is antithetical to everything that we think, that we believe in America. And if you look at the history, would segregation of public schools have won if that had been on the ballot? Would Jim Crow have ended if that had been put to a vote? Would interracial marriage be allowed in many states in this country if you put it to a vote even today? I don't think it would. That's why we don't put people's basic human rights to a vote. Rights are rights, and that's all there is to it. I would also say, on the same-sex marriage thing, is when I introduced my bill, there was a senator named Michael Berger who said he was going to introduce the opposite bill to constitutionalize discrimination in Pennsylvania, prohibiting any recognition of same-sex couples. Well, we had one debate, he and I, on Radio Times with Marty Moscowine. I don't know if anyone heard that debate, but it did not go well for him, okay? To the point where he refuses to debate ever again. And it's gotten to the point where I can't find someone on the other side willing to debate this issue in public. And it's not because I am a genius, although I am. That's not the reason, all right? The reason is because there is no rational, articulable argument against marriage equality. Let me just take a few seconds to tell you the arguments that we get. Number one, it's going to destroy opposite sex traditional marriage. To which the answer is, if that's true, you'd think we would have noticed it. There are five states and there are 25 nations that have full marriage equality. In all of those, we have seen no problems with opposite sex couples at all. It is a bogus argument. We also hear the slippery slope argument that if you allow a man to marry a man, you have no choice but to allow a man to marry his sister or three of his sisters or a cat or a lawnmower. You have no choice at that point. To which, again, we draw reasonable lines in the law all the time. You can carry a gun, you can't carry a truck bomb. All lawmaking is drawing lines. And the line should be drawn where it allows every person the chance to marry the one person they love the most in the world. That's a reasonable place to draw the line. The other argument we hear is that, you know, my God doesn't like it. And my first reply to that is always, well, my God does, which drives them crazy. But it doesn't matter because we don't live in a theocracy. I'm Jewish. My God teaches me you shouldn't eat pork. I don't eat pork. But I'm not introducing legislation to ban everyone else from eating pork. Okay? We live in a free society. If your religion doesn't approve of gay marriage, don't marry a gay person. That's fine. Okay? But there's nothing that allows people to force their religion on other people. So once the arguments are exposed as completely bogus arguments, they retreat and stop debating it's a bad situation for them. Now let me just say one more thing, which is this. People ask me when same-sex marriage will pass in Pennsylvania. and I sort of jokingly say about 3 weeks after Mississippi. Soon as Mississippi, we're right there, right behind this, and we'll be right there. Now, but I'm hoping that's not true. I'm hoping that we, for once, and you know, there was a time when we were a progressive state back during the time of Thomas Jefferson and George Washington. I'm hoping we once again are in dead last in terms of human rights and civil rights in this country. And that only will happen when you start demanding it. So I'm begging you, go to your legislator, even if they're hostile, go to your state senator, your state house member, meet with them. Make them understand why this is important, because many of them don't understand that that there are thousands of rights that are dependent on rights and benefits that are dependent on marriage in this state and in this nation. Make them understand you are denied all of those because you are not, quote, married. Make them understand that you just want to live your lives the way they live their lives. This is a pro-family initiative, that we want gay people and straight people to live monogamous, stable, legally recognized lives. It is a process of changing minds one at a time, and you are the people who need to do it. So thank you for being here today. Keep up the good work. I'm going to be with you every step of the way. Have a great day.